Welcome to Heartfully Creating. Hi, I'm Howard. Welcome to our creativity zone where Anita heartfully created me.
On today's polymer clay journey, I'm going to talk about a practical project in polymer clay called something just called a cord holder. We all have tangled messes of cords at home. The cord holder is something that is talked about in more detail in the corresponding blog, heartfullycreating.blogspot.com. So go there and check out the details. This one is the only one that wasn't part of the coil design that you'll see later on that I made that was a lot easier, a little more springy, but I just thought I'd try this idea first using a rectangle or square sheet of clay covered in a simple cane on I believe it was aluminum foil cardboard tube wrapped in wax paper. Then I left the end part that overlapped the next layer of clay as I wrapped it around like a diamond shape and then put wax paper tucked underneath. So when I baked it, I could remove the paper. You'll have to check out the blog to see the details on how that one was made. And it worked really well. You can insert the cords quite easily. And you have more coverage with that one. It's sturdier for bigger cords. This was a tinier one that I made using I use a lot of nail art supplies and polymer clay, including these cool sparkly powders. If you've been watching the blog at all, you know I have a whole collection of mica powders. I just thought I'd try some of these new things called chrome and chameleon powders. Turns out it's all about the technique and how they go on fingernails, but some of them do look really cool on clay. I find them a lot more in a finer powder, and they're a little gloppy looking because I don't know why. But I added some liquid clay on top and it kind of muddled up the colors. But in the end, it baked fine. So they were actually laid on two nail file metal tubes, not nail file, nail art metal tubes that I use a lot in clay ing, and wrapped it, everything in wax. Wax paper is a great release. So I wrap everything in wax paper. This is another one used on a cannoli making tube, which is made out of metal. Sorry, I lied. I just noticed there that was actually the aluminum paper cardboard tube. But I do use the cannoli tubes a lot. I bought a pack of six for a good price, and you can use them for rolling out your clay. They're only about maybe 4 to 5 inches long, and they're metal. So you can put them in the oven. Same with cardboard, though. And then I lay them on wax paper, as well as the tissue paper. I didn't want to put tissue paper, toilet paper, Kleenex. You can all put that in the oven when it's at 275 Fahrenheit, but just don't let that, of course, touch an element. I didn't want, because I used liquid clay on the surface, I didn't want to put it directly on the tissue because it would have stuck and baked right on there. So I used the tissue to make like a bed for it, and you don't have to cover them in liquid clay. I was just trying to, for some reason, I don't know why, I was just trying to protect the mica powder or the nail powder. You don't have to do that. So here's the baked finished results. This one is the one that's not the coil form, using just that rectangular kind of form or square form that I mentioned. And and then here it is in action. The coil ones are really easy. You just gently wrap them around your bundle of cords. Of course, I could make them look even neater than that, but I just couldn't wait to wrap them around something. This one is a lot tinier. It sits on my table by my computer, just holding together some extra cords that are too long. So I hope you're inspired to give that a try and come up with a practical way to deal with those excess tangled mess of cords that we so often have, even in the cordless world we are living in today. So thanks a lot for watching. And if you liked it, please subscribe, share, and like. And I'd love to hear how it went for you if you tried this. Any ideas too would be great.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and like and share if you want to. See you next time. Bye.